Vunaka, you're watching Talk Business, and to all our viewers who are joining us from around the region via Sky Pacific, welcome to the show. This week on Talk Business, we continue our coverage in Papua New Guinea, and we're featuring an agro-business that specializes in aromatic spices, essential and coconut oil. We're talking about Amruqa Enterprises, based out here in Vunakanau in the East New Britain province. Join us over the next half hour as we show you how a small business has joined forces with farmers in the coastal and the highlands to produce some of the best products that has the potential to become a large-scale industry. The beauty business is a billion-dollar industry the world over. In fact, in the United States alone, it rakes in a total revenue of about $54.89 billion annually. And a fast-growing component of the beauty industry are essential oils. Essential oils are derived from volatile aromatic components found in plants. They can be distilled or extracted from the flower, bark, seeds, leaves, or root of plants, or from the whole plant itself. And they're most sought after by the cosmetics, flower and fragrance industries, and of course the food sector. And a daring business in an outer province of Papua New Guinea has tapped into this potential. Amruqa is an organically certified business that produces essential oils from coconuts and a range of aromatic spices. The innovative venture is the brainchild of Ian Sexton and Teresa Eric, who realized long ago that essential oils would soon enough become the buzz in our cosmetic industry. From a small farm based out in Vunakanau, in Kokopo in the New East Britain province, the company works with villagers to grow high-quality spices and coconuts. What started out as a small business has grown into an export entity, where its products are sold to markets across Japan, New Zealand, Australia, and even Fiji. In the Pacific, coconut trees define our way of life. From our food to shelter to earning our keep, the tree of life has become a commodity we certainly can bank on. But what we don't realize is really how much coconuts can offer us. Talk Business is going to take a rare insight into just how essential oils are produced from coconuts. From Vunakanau in Kokopo, we are now headed to the coconut plantations. Amruqa gets its weekly supply from both villages in the interior of the province and along the coast. For many who tend to coconut plantations, their day begins quite early. This is Takakale village, where coconuts are in abundance. For villagers here, Amruqa provides a vital link to economic independence. And they get good value too. Villagers that provide their coconuts to the company simply gather the nuts. Amruqa takes care of the rest. Back at the factory, workers then begin the task of husking the coconuts.
The people doing the dehusking are well experienced in whether the coconut's too heavy, whether it's dark in colour, whether it has a certain smell to it, so they can grade out there quite quickly. Only the good and accepted coconuts come through to here. They're then broken, and the coconut water is kept, and then the meat of the coconut is taken out through a process called finger cutting. They actually call it finger cutting because they cut it into fingers, finger-like.
Once the coconut flesh has been weighed, it must thoroughly be cleaned. coconut flesh must be shredded before the essential oils are pressed out.
So once the coconut is brought out, it's washed, brought onto a draining board, and then it's put into the grater. Here is another a grating area where he himself will see the bits of shell or bits of coconut that shouldn't have come through. It's too low a grade, and he'll reject it at this point as well. So here the grated coconut is put into the milk extractor, or squeezer as we like to call it. And basically here it's just the milk is extracted and squeezed out and collected on this side.
After the coconuts have been grinded, it's put into the squeezer where the coconut cream is extracted.
The screening and vibration machine. If the coconut milk is screened into here, it passes through this machine which screens out any foreign material. And it also shakes the milk up, which helps separate the oils from the particles of oils from within the milk compound.
And now on to the final stage of the pre-process of oil extraction.
Using the centrifuge, the milk is cleaned and processed there. It's passed through into the centrifuge itself, which spins at high resolution and separates the water. Then it'll separate the cream. The creamy, oily coconut milk is passed and collected into here. And it's from that we'll get the end virgin oil from.
And finally, the sealing and packaging. Amruqa maintains that for rural communities in PNG and across the region, coconuts are still very important to the Pacific way of life.
Rather than just individual farmers, we look at it as a community project where the entire community can participate and therefore they all benefit from, and you can do that with the coconut. That is something you can do with the coconut.
Amruqa is one of the 42 enterprises from across the Pacific that is being assisted by the European Union-funded Increasing Agricultural Commodity Trade, or IACT, project. IACT's role in the region is simple: to enable Pacific businesses to become export-oriented and market-driven enterprises. Amruqa has received a whopping US $70 million as part of its facility upgrade program. Assistance means the company now has a brand new coconut oil processing machinery and related equipment. This will improve efficiency and enable Amruqa to produce up to 10 tons of coconut oil per month for exports.
The equipment that will be handed over today will be used for processing of quality coconut oil to meet international food safety standards. Acquiring such standards will open the door for Amruqa to export to larger global markets. I'm sure that the timely intervention provided by the European Union through the IAC project will enhance business prospects and leading to expansion and growth of this enterprise.
For the European Union, it's also about helping companies like Amruqa reach their long-term goals. Being able to tap into new export markets is a realization of aspirations made possible through the IAC project.
Our aim is to work together with groups and companies like Amruqa to help increase the production of world-class agricultural exports in Papua New Guinea and other Pacific countries.
Even more so, as Amruqa is a vital link towards the empowerment of rural communities in Kokopo.
Amruqa is contributing to providing employment to the rural people here. Amruqa is providing them some income, not only to the workers, but also to those farmers that are selling their coconuts to Amruqa. Amruqa is positively involved in the fight to reduce poverty, and Amruqa is also contributing to the commercial and economic growth of cocoa.
Amruqa is a success story, no doubt. To operate a business in the interior of PNG and be able to export to markets across the globe is an achievement in itself.
It's extremely difficult to start up a business from scratch, or once you've started up a business, to begin exporting. You know, there are certain standards that you need to meet. You need to understand the markets. You need to understand how to research the markets. And very importantly, you need to know how to have an edge over your competitors so that you can really be successful. You need to know about how to get financing. You need to know who to approach to get loans. And you need to know about the complexities of the markets that you're going to be looking for. So all of these things are very important in the framework of IAC. We provide support in all of these areas, and we're very pleased with some of the success stories that have come about.
For Pacific countries, forming synergies outside the region also means exploiting opportunities that do not exist in our part of the world. This makes the role of IAC even more important.
The expertise that we've made available, and through SPC has been running the program for us. So the expertise that has been provided has really, I think, helped the entrepreneurs to achieve what they really set out to do. I think we've been surprised about the success of the program, but I think that goes to show that there is a real entrepreneurship in the Pacific countries. But very often you just need to, let's say, exploit the opportunities that are there. You need to make people aware of what they can do. You need to make people aware of the markets. And certainly it's been very important to get people to understand that there are opportunities out there. They're not always easy to grasp, but with hard work, with expertise, you can certainly make a success of your business.
For Amruqa, the EU-funded IAC project has meant much more than mere financial assistance. It's enabled the business to enhance its unique business model, known as the Fusion Enterprise Engagement Model. This allows Amruqa to link communities to global export markets while respecting cultural values and living in harmony with the ecosystem.
Thank you to the SPC and thank you to the EU. But what this has done is it's enabled us to improve our product flows and have more efficiency when processing. And with the added machinery, the squeezer that has been purchased under the project, that will enable us to get to critical mass.
Amruqa hopes to bring the value-adding process to source so farmers get more value for their products. What this means is that more responsibility taken on by farmers, the better the return.
We want to really develop and have not us just collecting coconuts to make the oil, but actually teaching the farmers to sort the coconuts. Which comes down to quality. What coconuts can go to oil, they can send to us. What coconuts cannot go to oil, they can then make what we would like to term now dried white coconut.
There's no denying the potential of the essential oil business, which is why Amruqa knows that apart from virgin coconut oil, they could also easily extract essential oils from other viable plants. And what better than aromatic spices? In fact, the idea first came about after farmers approached the company seeking markets for their cardamom. It was then when Ian realized that spices could prove a profitable diversification crop for farmers.
So we were able to find a market for them in Germany. We then grew production from, I think it was 800 kilos up to 60 tons by just having a readily available market for farmers.
Slowly, Amruqa began planting its own range of spices to meet the growing demand, as essential oils derived from spices were proving popular. Nutmeg and pepper were the first experiments.
So the first ones were naturally cardamom because we had a lot of it, nutmeg. But then we looked further afield into other crops that we could actually grow or were already growing here, such as citronella, lemongrass, patchouli. And we've actually introduced tea tree from Australia in the last 2 years, which is a high value, high production essential oil, which will be very beneficial to farmers.
Ensuring the product meets international demands has allowed the company to break out into new markets. The stringent Japanese market is an example. Amruqa can sell its essential oils at premium prices.
For the Japanese market, where they'll actually buy about 6 of our products, and they'll make a finished product in Japan, which is solely from the origin of Amruqa. And they'll do a range of lip balm, face cream, face wash. I think there's 4 products which they actually make from our total range of products.
But while essential oils may be a lucrative business, it doesn't come about without its own unique challenges, especially when it's a country like PNG, where the essential oils industry is fairly new and the issues can become complex.
The key problem here is getting to critical mass, and over the years, as transport costs, fuel costs, export costs, shipping costs, it's all cost, and the margins are actually quite slim when it comes to small volumes.
So to reach the critical mass, it's important for Amruqa to strengthen their relationship with smallholder farmers that grow spices on their land. This way, the company ensures there's always a constant supply of spices for essential oils.
They rely on us just as much as we rely on them now, and it's really grown into a relationship rather than trading partnership. We work with them on their education needs and their health needs, and there's a lot of instances when we've been into remote areas and we've actually left product behind to bring sick people in. So it's that sort of relationship that we develop with them, rather than it just being, as I said earlier, a straight trading relationship.
Now let's tour the spice farm.
Okay, this is pepper plant. Again, this has been imported from Indonesia. Once it's growing, it takes about 18 months to 2 years to actually start producing peppercorns. When you're testing it to see whether it's ripe or ready for harvest, you pick a small peppercorn and then you just squish it between your two fingers. And if it breaks, as this one has, it hasn't matured yet. Generally, it'll grow in size and it'll change in colour. So you can see some of them here. For example, this one. I'll take this one off. You can see it's much bigger in size, the peppercorn, and also when you go to press it like this, you can't do it. So this is actually ready for harvest.
Ian believes farmers can get much more returns if they engage in crop diversification and proper land utilization.
When we planted the pepper, we also planted chili through the interrows, and we planted turmeric as well. Now the chili will be harvestable in 6 months, which gives them something to sell. The turmeric can be harvested at 9 to 10 months, which gives them something to sell. And then the following year, the pepper, 18 months, is harvestable, and that can be sold as well. This is the nutmeg fruit. When it ripens on the tree, it opens, and eventually it'll either open completely and the seed will fall to the ground and it's collected, or the whole thing will fall and break as it hits the floor. This is tea tree. We've introduced it from Australia with selected seed and brought in through quarantine regulations in Australia and PNG. So it's taken nearly 2 years to get the seed in here. But the idea is that we start with a known end result, in that we know that the quality of this oil and the production quantities will meet our expectations.
Amruqa is also experimenting with tea tree oil. Villages, the spices have proven to be a profitable alternative to their coconuts. This ensures a steady income for the many that depend on commercial agriculture to get by. Once the spices have been harvested, it is then dried before the essential oils are extracted. And that's the show for this week. We'd love to hear from you, so do send us an email, talkbusiness@pgtv.com.fj. Remember, you can catch me on the net on our YouTube channel as well as our Facebook page. And if you have a Twitter account, follow me at @RachnaPGTV. Until next time, have a productive week.